But with Jesus, I can see the will of God. And this word came to me, about be aware, but be not in fear. Be aware, but be not in fear. We need to be aware. You know, if you hear some shaking outside, you want to look at something myself about it, because it's not normal to hear different sounds saying what's going on. So in this world, there's a so much going on. And I'm going to look at the scripture taken from, I say, Matthew's. I think it's Matthew 24. Yes, it's in Matthew chapter 24, verse 15. Let me read it to you the first time. It says, when ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place, whoso liveth understand, then let them that are in Judea flee to the mountains, and let them which are on the housetop come down. Take nothing out of his house. Neither let him which is in the field return back to take clothes. And woe unto them that are with child, and unto them that give suck in those days. But pray that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath. For then shall be a great tribulation, such as not since the beginning of time of the world to this time, no even shall be, except those days be shortened. There shall no flesh be saved, but for the next day those days shall be shortened. Then if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, and ye believe it not, and there shall be false Christ, false prophet, and shall show great wonders, insomuch as if it were possible, they would deceive the very elect. Behold, I have told you before. Wherefore, if he shall say unto you, behold, he is in the desert, go not forward. He is in the secret chamber, believe it not. For as the lightning cometh out of the east and shineth unto the west, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. And wherever the compass is, there will the eagles be gathered. Praise the Lord. Amen. Father, we thank you for your word. We pray you will bless your word. We pray you will inspire with your word. I pray, Lord, you speak to your people, Lord, and let your word go forth and accomplish what you've sent. Hallelujah. And let it not return on mountain of wine. We thank you, we praise you, we sanctify and glorify your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now I was looking at, you know, what is the Lord saying to me, to us today. We are living in a very serious time. We are to be aware of where we are. Jesus, 2,000 years ago, said these words, and we're witnessing the things that Jesus told us about right now. And even it said, trouble in the last days, evil men shall wax worse and worse. Have you seen that? He says that they shall be, well, this way, put it this way. When Jesus was up on the mount, his disciples came to him and privately said to him, tell us, when shall these be, things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming? The Lord Jesus didn't say, don't worry. But he went step by step and tell them what will happen.
Yes.
Let no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name. Everybody's talking about Jesus. Everybody knows Jesus. If we don't know him, the Bible says, if it were possible, deceiver would deceive the very elect. But because God has been elect, we cannot be deceived. Because when God saved us, he put something in us that blocked out all deception. We cannot be deceived if it was possible. But everyone said, I am Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone said, I am for the Lord. Everyone said, I am for God. But Jesus says, Be not deceived. Let them, the time is, we're in time when trouble is on the left side. Trouble is everywhere. I don't know if you realize what is happening around us. I can go into details because nowadays, every time I pick up my phone, I see things, I can't follow it. I can't catch up with it. Because every day is something new. Every day there's something going on in every corner. And we hear so much about wars and rumors of war. Jesus told us it's a sign.
Yes.
So, brethren, when we see these signs, the Bible says, when we see these signs, look up.
Yes, amen.
Brethren, we are in look up time.
Amen.
We see through our eyes. We hear through our ears.
Yes.
The Bible says, he who has ears, let him hear.
Amen. Amen.
Not everybody who has ears can hear. And not everyone that has eyes can see. But he who has ears, let him hear. Because God is speaking to us. From the dead. The only man